Hi guys. Well, I'm getting somewhere. When I turned the camera off last night, I did loop all these ones together. They're all in parallel. I can run them off that battery, but that battery is actually getting low, so they don't light very brightly. Just got to make sure I get the wires around the right way. Four of them do flash. So I'm going to try and get these wires on here and hold them in one hand. Yeah, that one there is pretty dim. That should be better once I've got them hooked to that. But I'm just using the battery just to make sure they work before I hook them to that. So that's one shelf done. I'm going to put that on the end here, so this cable is going to be put up most entirely somehow over there. To do the metal one, I had to use a special adapter. It's about the size of one of these 6-volt batteries, but you can put D cell batteries in them. Those, four of those. So I've put one of those in, but just connected the wires to the spring terminals, because I couldn't do it any other way, because the actual light unit itself kept falling out. So I put that in there, just to make sure the light unit doesn't fall out. I've got nowhere to attach wires to this one without soldering, and I don't particularly want to do that to that one. But I do have another one of those adapters that I can use. So I'll be using that. So the next task is to find some more cable, preferably with markings on, so I can do the next shelf. I'm not sure I've got enough. And then I can put where they're gone. Those ones that are 12 volt powered, I will put on the end of the shelf there. I was actually thinking of switching each shelf with an individual switch, because I've got some more of these somewhere in this lot. I'll throw them up here somewhere, so, oh, there's one. I've got some more that aren't exactly like that, but I can use them. There's the other one, so there's two I can use. And the switches, they still operate on these, so I can still turn them on and off individually if I wanted to. But I figured, as a precaution, I'd switch them individually. Right, so I've got to take that wire off, haven't I? I need to find a kettle lead as well. So I should be able to reach the power socket down there, because there's only one plugged into it, I think, if I remember correctly. Oh, no, I need that for something else. I was thinking I could have used that, but I might need that for something else. AKA those lights. I've got two extension sockets down here as well. But I'm not sure if I've got any free. Have I got any free? I've got one free. So I don't know how many mains lights I'm going to be putting in this window yet. I may not actually need that. Oh, bananas, my battery's going dead. Well, oh well, I'll change the batteries and carry on with those lights and come back, I suppose. So, so much easier holding this camera with a tripod attached. Even if it is one of them stupid little ones with the bendy legs. Does its job, though. Yes, I'm going to do that, I think. And hopefully by then I should have the actual power supply in place as well. So fiddly. I've had to do it with the lights on the shelf, mostly because I couldn't get them all in my arms to put them back up on the shelf. If I took them down and did them on the bed. So I sort of did the first three on the bed, and then the rest I did while they were up on the shelf. So I could actually do with going down to the shed and getting a stepladder. That might make life a little bit easier. So I think I'll do that as well. I'll find a home for those paraffin lamps. I'm not sure where I'm going to put those. Balls. I'll find some way I can hang them somewhere, I'm sure of it. I don't know where, but I'll find some way to hang them. So I'm going to change the batteries in the camera, get on with some more work, and I'll be back later. Sort of a change of plan. I haven't done any of those. I decided, before I went any further, I'd have a move around. So now, literally, all my computers and consoles and even the TV is all in one spot. which is better. Because now I can just sit on the bed and the PS2 and PS1 is hooked to this TV. I've got it going through that splitter, so I just flick the switch between 1 and 2 and I can go between PS2 and PS1. I don't know, I just felt like that was easier to do it that way, as the only AV input left was that one. There's only one SCART on this. The Mega Drive is also connected up there. I haven't tuned that in yet. I'll tune that in later. Power supply for the laptop down there. VCR is down on the floor. Amstrad is on that bottom shelf. Sinclair is there. Mega Drive down there. Still not got the PCs in, but I can plug those in as and when I want to play with them. And the ledge is clear. Spitter is still up there. He's made lots and lots of wonderful cobwebs under here as well. I don't know if the camera's going to pick him up. He's been a busy bee under here as well. You might see some fluff dangling under there. I'm going to put this probably over there. Hopefully between here and the power outlet, so I can access the power outlet. There's a fair bit of weight in there because all the DVDs and tapes are still in there. So that'll be the next job, and well, actually I'll do that last, because I'll go get the ladder, and I'll do a bit more wiring, I think, if I can find some wiring. Well, I may try and set that up. Yeah, that's what I might do. I may try and set the power supply up, see how well it's going to run what's there on a 5-volt rail. We'll find out. May not keep one of those tildons up there. Might take one down. Because one is sort of a bodge I did to get it working. It's just a static instead of a flash, because all contacts and shit all basically went to shit beyond repair. It had been kicking around too long with a dead battery, and the other one's perfectly fine. I'm actually pretty certain the one that I modified was this one. Yeah, it still works. I haven't got the security bolt in this one, because they were quite a pain in the flipping ass to get in and out of there, so... Yeah, so next shelf will be this one. And I'll just have a... the M12 volts on here and the miscellaneous ones. I'm gonna try and figure something out with this one, because it would be nice to get that one working on the display, you know. So I've got some unusual ones. I got the cobwebs out of that corner. You're a little asshole, you know that. He's right there, black dot, centre screen. Right. There, little harvest spider. Well, apparently they're not actually spiders, so I've heard. Oh, no, I'm thinking of the other one. I'm thinking of another one, not that one. That's a proper, I think that's a proper harvest. Cat is asleep, as always. I've just been outside and took some photos of North Walsham Fire Station, as I was politely asked by a fellow enthusiast on my Facebook, so I thought I'm not really doing anything at the moment, and it's just across the street, so I might as well. Yeah. Next step, find some more cable, and, hello, someone is at the door. Ooh, let's have a look, shall we? Who's there? Hello? Ah, that's right, it's just the electrician fixing the light on the landing. Someone has shut the door and shut him out. I put the outside light on for him as well, because it's bloody dark out there. Despite big windows, it is dark out on that landing for some reason. Always has been. Even worse this time of year. Well, that's the update for now. I will come back again shortly when I've finally done some more. Get some more done in here. Got 12 volts there to do. Do those last. It's only three lights. Well, actually, it's three lights, but I only need two cables because the red and orange ones are connected together. I've just got to remember which ones you, which one you're supposed to put the battery in, because it'll only work one way. But I'll sort all that out later, and I'll be back. So, ta-ta for now. Right. So far, that shelf is done. That shelf is done. I've just got to seat the light unit in this one properly, and that one's actually stopped working. But I know what the problem is with that one, so I'll deal with that in a bit. Probably after dinner, because I've got dinner on. But I have got these ones all rigged up. All I've got to do is go, when I can find a switch. Blue, I think the blue one just looks dim. I don't think it actually. That's just the angle we were standing at. Right. I've just got to connect that one. I'm going to attach switches. I haven't attached a switch yet. I just want to attach switches so I can switch each shelf on. That might ease on the sudden current draw as well when I might turn this on. So yeah, it'll be just the 12 volt ones to do after this. Yeah, bodge on a couple of switches for the time being, because at the moment I've just got the master switch there. Actually, let's turn it back on again. Should we turn the light off? See what the shelf is, first shelf is like with the light off. Ooh. One of those, that doorman right there, second from the right, has got a slow flash on it for some reason. And yet there's the one directly to its right, or directly to the left, I should say. Is an identical lamp. Blue one. Static amber. The static amber one up there is only a single-sided lens. But I actually thought that this one right here was a static lamp, not a flash, but it's a flash. So that means I've been looking for a flash for no reason. I need the static version, because I know they do it in a static version. Right, getting there. That'll be the next one, so when I next turn the video on, hopefully I'll have switches in place. And this one sorted, so I'll be back later. Alright, last segment of this video, I think, for today. Anyway, all sorted. So, switch down here. I will do a much better job than that. I will make a little box up or something to put the switches in. And, nothing working yet. Now I've got to remember which one does which. This one's right shelf. That Batchley one is on, it just not showing very well with the light on. I'll turn the light off in a second. And that one does left shelf. Switch the light off. You know, they're not as bright as they should be, but they're bright enough for display purposes. I thought the Renix one was actually a static one. It's the second one in from the right hand side. Almost a power flash. One, two. Only three steady burn ones. Static. Right. Well, I might do the other shelf tonight. I don't know, but I won't film it if I do. I've got this. What's the lamps down here? I can't do the Epco, not without drilling into the case, so I'll have to stick a battery in that one to demo that, but that doesn't matter. Yeah, they're all wired in parallel, by the way, so I've just literally just looped one to the other. Getting hot in here. Nope, stone cold. But like I said, the plus 5 volt rail on this is 30 amps max. And I presume that's all 5 volt outputs together, not individually. No, I assume that's the rail as a whole. But I can't remember what I said the 12 volt was now. But that's well within the limits. Can't remember what the wattage is of, or the amps, I should say, is of one of these bulbs. Not off the top of my head. A few down here. Yeah, I haven't bothered with the maxi lights because, I might add one on the end or on the next shelf down because I've got to solder the wires onto the light unit. I don't mind doing it to a maxi light. That one there rather than that one there, because I've got stacks more of those down in the shed. You know, they're so plentiful, there's loads. You still get them on eBay. Oh, pardon me. And JSP have the LED versions on their website. Probably won't do this one because I've got to solder wires to that as well. I suppose I could tape them down, but there wouldn't be a very good connection with it. Oh, I didn't know that. Comes unhooked. Just bear with me one second while I try and close that back up. Oh, I see. I suppose it's not entirely a bad thing, is it? I'm going to try and do some of these ones as well on this shelf. So I'm going to put the 3 12 volt lamps on this end, and then just fill the other end up, perhaps with some of these. The only problem is, some actually won't show, because I've got photocell in. I can't remember which ones it is. But never mind. I'll probably get... Can I do these ones? I've got a little hole in the bottom, I might be, or I've got a hole there I might be able to get a wire into. I don't know. I'll have to pop the top off and have a look. How about this one? Yeah, it's got a little hole in the bottom as well. And then the side for a handle that this model obviously didn't come with. We're running for a bit, are we? What? Blowing nice cold air out the back, so it's not getting hot. It's actually pretty awesome. I can run these probably for as long as I want. And whatever shelf I want, you know, if I don't fancy having a right-hand shelf off. Oh, my God, did it turn it off? That's the whole reason I added the switches. But yeah, I will make a proper switch box, I think. Tunnel. So there we go. I'm sort of stuffed because I've just eaten. So anyway. I do believe it's another foggy night. Yeah, it's a little bit foggy out there. Anyway, thanks a lot for watching. I will update you on further progress, and hopefully when I'm done, I can have all three shelves lit up. So I've got 12 so far. 6 on each shelf. Pardon me. I've got to try and find a 9-volt battery I can put in this one, because I think I took the other one out. I'm pretty certain I've got one. Whether it'll work or not, I don't know. Just sort of like my ghost lamp, you know, there's no battery compartment. And there's the terminals, but I can make it work. I'm clever. I'll show you how I did that in another video. Yeah. Thanks a lot for watching. Thumbs up the video if you liked it. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos. And we'll talk to you again soon. Bye.